Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast, episode 795. Now, in the United States, we're off today. It's the 4th of July, Independence Day. But we're going to do a couple of, actually several different things today, a couple of quick little tricks. First of all, usually when I'm doing my seminar, I never cover this in the seminar, but people start to say, well, hey, how are you switching from sheet to sheet to sheet so fast without using the mouse? And so, the way that I do this is to hold down the control key and hit page down to move to the right, or page up to move to the left. Great way to very quickly move through your worksheets. And so I always show this trick, and at the Data Analyst Boot Camp down in Plano last time, Al from US Gas and Electric, he taught me a new one. He said, okay, well, control page down and page up is great for moving through the worksheets, but what if you need to move screenfuls of data to the right? That's Alt page down. So here I'm sitting in column A. I can see A through O on my screen. When I press Alt page down, it automatically moves me over to P. And now I can see through AD. I hit Alt page down again, it moves one screen full of data to the right. Alt page up, of course, moves one whole screen full of data back to the left. So, another great way to move very quickly through the spreadsheets. Another cool thing, if you have a mouse with a wheel on it, the scroll wheel, hold down the control key while you move the wheel and you can very quickly zoom in and zoom out. Just try it, you'll see which way moving up basically will zoom in, and then the other way will zoom out. All right, so those are just some quick tips. Now I have a question for you. Usually when I talk about the fill handle, I always show, you know, that it can't fill the number one. I grab the fill handle and drag, and it just fills 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And so if you hold down the control key, well, then Excel can actually extend the 1 into 2, 3, 4, 5. But then I had someone who said, well, look, I have this data here with these borders, and normally when I grab the fill handle and drag, it brings all of my borders down, and then I have to open this icon and choose fill without formatting. Great, but that fails when we use the number 1. When we use the number 1, we hold down the control key in order to get it to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It brings the borders down, and then when we open this and change to fill without formatting, it automatically changes back to ones. How frustrating is that? So, write to me, bill@mrexcel.com. Let me know how you would fill that series without bringing the borders down. Well, have a great weekend. We'll see you next week for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.